What's good guys, I'm Pradeep from Arm Wrestling Noobs. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to do a breakdown of Monster Michael Todd versus Khalid Jashel match. Most of you guys by now know who Khalid is. He is a 25-year-old guy from Cameroon who is working as a mechanic in Dubai. He has done a little bit of table training, maybe once every few months for past 2 years, and 2-3 times every month for past 3 months. They have started calling him Khalid Iron Grip Jashel for a reason. I believe this dude can break almost every world record in grip disciplines in a year or two if he decides. Larry often says in this video that he has the strongest grip in the world. So let's get to the match. Michael Todd obviously saw before coming to Dubai that his schoolboy cannot slip out of Khalid's hand. In fact, nobody could slip out of his hands. The first thing he wanted to see is if he can slip out of his hand or not. And to Michael's surprise, he couldn't. Man, Khalid loves people's thumbs so much, he just can't let go of it. And remember, Michael always does the underhand slip as he pronates his hand out and under the opponent's hand, which according to Devon is the easiest way to slip. And even that way he cannot slip for a good 10-20 seconds. So Todd puts the straps on and Devon commented about it and even made a video reminding Michael Todd that you first wrap the strap around the arm of a person who has the buckle. So Michael used the hustle strap on himself and was in a disadvantageous position from the beginning. Now for those of you who don't know what that means, I'll give a link in the description where Devon explains all of this. So in the straps, Michael lets Khalid go first and he immediately folds Michael's wrist back, just like he did to schoolboy. And Michael drops to the king's move. Now that's very interesting. If you guys have been following Michael for long enough, you must have heard him say a dozen times that he can arm wrestle in any style. He has to use the king's move only when there is money on the line or he's facing an elite guy. So that kind of tells you what level Khalid is at. Finally, after 1 minute and 15 seconds, Michael was able to get behind his shoulder and press. And I know guys like Ryan Bowen who just cannot digest the fact that amateurs can be as strong or even stronger than him. Guys like him would say that, yeah, but Michael did not try. Michael was enjoying the game. He was allowing Khalid. But that's not the truth. He even said that there is nothing impressive in Khalid's grip. There are 8 guys around him that have a stronger grip than Khalid. Dude, Larry knows a thing or two about grip. There are not 8 guys even in the world that have a stronger grip than Khalid. If Ryan had the power, he would crucify all the beginners except for the one who buy his shirts and pay for his monthly online coaching. And by the way, the things that Ryan said about me in this post were complete lies. I did not say anything like that. You can watch that video if you want, it's still there. Michael has one of the best endurance in the world. Every workout that he does has some kind of cardio in it. Even Devon gassed out before him in 2018. But only after one pull, Michael was the one who was breathing heavy. And when your arms are pouring sweat, it means you really tried. Some of the things that Michael said about Khalid. There is no getting out of his hand. He had the chance to press me. My arm was as straight as it can go. He almost beat me. That's as far as I have ever been pushed in a practice in a long time. I cannot peel his wrist back. People think that Michael can crack Levon's wrist back, but he himself admits that he cannot do that to Khalid. And did you guys notice the chill on Khalid's face? I mean, he's got the guy who's clearly top 3 in the world in front of him, completely sweating, out of breath, and all nervous. And he's just standing at the table, chalking his hand while Michael Todd is waiting for him to get to the table. I bet you can put anyone against him and he would not be bothered or intimidated. And that's a very good thing if you want to seek higher level of competition. So round 2. Michael hits off the go as hard as he can for the top roll and Khalid stops him and squeezes the life out of his thumb for 1 minute before Michael bails out with an underhand slip. In the straps, Michael tries to flash press. Khalid's elbow goes flying off the pad, but he stops Michael and then folds his wrist again. And then Todd gets behind his shoulder from a weird position and presses him. We all know what Khalid's strength is, his gigantic hand and fingers. And it is not refined yet, but he can King's move, which could be a dangerous thing for many pullers after a few years. So let's talk about his weaknesses. First one that Michael brought up, speed. He takes about half of a second to engage his power. So if he's pulling a fast guy, he is already at a disadvantage. The second one, which I noticed, he is vulnerable to an inside move. We have seen how he dominates Larry outside of his straps, and yet Larry was able to beat him almost every time they were strapped up. I know Michael can press anyone in this world, but when he got behind his shoulder and opened Khalid's arm, and it was about arm strength and not just hand, Khalid did not look strong. So, let's talk about who should face Khalid in 2021. First opponent, Levon. He is the only guy that can give Khalid trouble. I'm just kidding, guys. I bet I got some of you mad at me.
And I think 2021, Khalid over Levon.
Okay, let's be practical. I want to see him versus Strom Shalino. Pretty much a hand-based arm wrestler like Khalid. Everyone in North America talks about how strong Storm's hand is. Let's see if he can deal with Khalid. I would put my money on Khalid in that match. Why? Two reasons. In the hand, where Storm is strong, Khalid is stronger. Much stronger. Two, Storm does not have an elite inside game, so he cannot force Khalid in a hook. So basically, is Khalid invincible? No, he isn't. In fact, I can tell you a 190-pound WL guy who can give a world of trouble to Khalid. Craig Touye. Super fast and explosive inside hit. Probably can force Khalid in a hook and pin him even before he engages his hand. Provided he does not turn Touye's thumb purple in the setup. If this version of Khalid goes against Craig, I think Craig beats him. But in the WL, with all the bullying going on in the setup, I think Khalid may be able to do to Craig what he did to Storm. Third match versus RVJ. That would be the best learning match for Khalid. Although Rob has a big hand, I don't think he can top roll Khalid like he did to Schoolboy a couple of years ago. But keeping in mind his bicep and cupping power, he can and will force Khalid inside. I would say that Rob wins that match. But that could be the only time he beats Khalid. Because there would be so much for him to learn from this match. I think he can make a comeback and get his revenge in a year. Fourth match versus Ryan Bowen. Come on guys, feed Ryan Bowen to Khalid already. We already know that Ryan is going to face Khalid at some time in near future. I reported that when Ryan proposed this match. Ryan Bowen, I think you're gonna get killed, man. You are hoping that somehow you will be able to out-arm wrestle him in the later rounds and bleed him out. That's just not gonna happen. Michael Todd gassed out against him. Ryan knows that despite the fact that Ryan is an experienced arm wrestler, he is the one who is going to be intimidated when Khalid squeezes his thumb, because Khalid is not afraid to arm wrestle anyone. Ryan cannot top roll him, and he's not fast enough to force him in a hook. I'm not the only one who thinks that. These are some screenshots from the Reddit group. People think that Khalid is a very bad matchup for Ryan. Khalid has definitely got arm wrestling world on its toes now. There is nothing wrong with his behavior. I see people saying that he has improved his behavior. There was nothing wrong with it in the first place, guys. That's it for this video. My name is Pradeep, and I thank you so much for watching.